Yo. We back once again with the True Hip Hop Podcast. It's your boy DJ Blaze.
And that guy again.
Wolverine, we back for episode 133.
You and me.
Hey, that's how we do. But before we get started, make sure y'all subscribe to the channel.
Right now.
Like, comment, and share.
Right now.
It helps us out tremendously on the algorithm. Me and Wolf appreciate all the
love
y'all been giving us. Come but y'all ain't been subscribing, so hit that bell.
Bing. I'm there.
Right now, and make sure it's all notifications. You heard me?
You hear me.
All right, man. Me and Wolf finna dive right into it, man. Yesterday, Charleston White was on DJ Academics podcast, and he was talking about how he made Soulja Boy in the face. You know what I'm saying?
Pepper spray.
You know what I'm saying? And he said he didn't want no beef with the kid, and he'll fight anybody, stab nigga, hit him with a railroad nail, anything if they come near him. Well, he did get Soulja.
He said, "What do you find out with that? A railroad? You gonna really pull one out, motherfucker?
You really stroke some nice, you know?" And then it was a Pyru Blood that checked him when he was down at the Rolling Loud concert, and he was hiding behind his girl. You know what I'm saying?
Hiding, like
he put her in front of him.
First he was talking tough, and then he slid
like he wanted to fight.
Girl. Then he slid behind this girl. Yeah. Are you on camera?
Mm-hmm. It was like, take it through the alley. He wasn't talking tucked in. It was like the alley right there. You know? And then he gonna wait to do, put him back. Then he wanna start
talking. Are you on the camera? No, do all the stuff on camera now?
Yeah, he waited till the camera got on him.
We on the camera now?
Y'all be careful with Charleston White, man. Because I believe he's an FBI agent, man. I really believe that he's a plant in hip-hop, and he's stirring up this controversy to get y'all locked up. Man. I truly believe it. How he talked, and he said, the police taught him how to spray mace. What police tell you that? Hey, what man. Police
when
tell you
come
that,
around,
bro?
Man, well, you just got to spray us like this. You got to spray us in the circle.
He said the police taught man. I'm convinced you're an agent.
Yeah, you're an agent. You been knew he was a snitch ass.
I didn't listen to him, so I wasn't paying attention. But now it's gone so far that man. You got to hear him. You know what I'm saying? That's why he's saying F King Von people, F Nipsey Hussle. He trying to stir up. He trying to get y'all locked up, man. I'm telling you.
Because each person he get locked up, he get money for it. He said it. He said, every person I get locked up, I get money for
right?
it. So I can bait you niggas to come right? in here and do this shit so I can call the police and get you locked up.
And he said he'll call the police too. Like, this dude crazy. We figuring it out, y'all, man. Charleston White is the police.
Is the police? He been saying the police.
Oh, I didn't know that. I just figured it out.
He been saying it.
A couple
said it a
videos
long time
ago.
That he was the police.
See, I didn't listen to him a long time ago. I'm just now hearing the dude.
I know he a rat ass dude.
Yeah. He said it. He said it plenty of times that he a rat.
Yeah.
Then he'll call the police and, yeah, he's setting cats up, man. Don't fall for the okie doke, y'all. You know what I'm saying? Please, y'all rappers, don't feed it. Soulja Boy, King
Let
Kong, people, all y'all, man, don't.
Let him go. Let that rat hit back in the sewers.
He said, F Nipsey Hussle, free Eric Garner.
He got something to say about everybody who's dead.
Yeah, to rile up their people. You know what I'm saying?
Man, listen. He ain't saying about nobody alive or out.
Because he know it's controversy if you say talk about the dead like that.
Yeah,
man.
It's a shock value.
Yeah, and people falling for this. Man.
I got a cousin who watched that bullshit.
Yeah, he straight up was. Because I ain't never heard no man talk so reckless about the dead and people.
And he always talking about black people this, but he always trying to down black people. Bro.
Yeah, he really down black people. He started a lot of shit too, man.
Man, this dude was
big
sick,
time.
Man. This dude was sick in the head.
Yeah.
He's sick.
Yeah, something wrong with this
He's
cat,
sick.
Man. Like,
he cross-eyed at everything.
If y'all like this dude, man, and support him, y'all crazy, man. Don't give him no attention, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't fall for the okie doke. That's all I gotta say about that.
It's real easy to do that when we're dealing with that dude. Because he talks so much trash.
Right.
You could be like, man, I can't take that, though. I gotta bust his head.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah. So stay away from him and Vlad.
Stay away from him and Vlad.
Yeah, yeah. They setting y'all up, boy. Them hip hop plants and they cops.
Man.
Yeah. Yep. That's the black version of Vlad.
Wow.
All right, man. We got to move on, man. Yesterday in Hip Hop DX, man, Eminem challenged Snoop Dogg to a battle
versus the
on a song, the LBC to the D. Mm. You know, well, who do you think had the better verse, and how do you feel about this song?
I couldn't hear any one of their verses, man. It was like, I don't know. It was spitting fast, but
they was really rapping fast. And I think Eminem baited Snoop to rap like that, you know. Eminem, to me, had the better verse. He did have some metaphors. I know you probably didn't catch it, but I did when he was like Mary Jane. That was a double.
Yeah, I did.
That was a double metaphor.
Yeah, Mary Jane. You know, Mary, you married the Jane.
Yeah, that was a slick metaphor right there.
I mean, I heard it all, and, but you know, I mean, I listened.
The contract killer part.
Yeah,
got more hits than the contract killer. You know what I'm saying? So I feel that he had the better bars than Snoop. You know, I don't think that was Snoop Lane. Yeah, he fed into Eminem style. You know what I'm saying? Instead of rapping how he rapped, because you couldn't hear Snoop at all, man. I can't remember one line he said. You know, and that's crazy because Snoop didn't come with lyrics when he on a song with another person. He didn't take it to the old school. You know,
he took it to the metaverse Snoop.
Yeah,
metaverse Snoop, the new Fro Snoop.
Yeah. Yeah, I get out with the Eminem, man. Mm. Song was okay, but
it was okay.
Yeah, the video was kind of sweet though.
I like the video.
The video was good, you know. Yeah. No, but I don't feel it has any replay value. I wouldn't play it.
Man.
He said, man.
I wouldn't even know where to start at.
Yeah, I don't know, but I give it to him for them couple metaphors. All right.
I give him a 7 out of 10.
That's cool. That's fair.
That's fair.
All right, man. Let us know what y'all think. Who won that, man? Eminem or Snoop Dogg?
Oh, Snoop Dogg. All
right, man. Yesterday in XXL magazine is Cash Money versus No Limit Soldiers, man. We want to know what y'all think, man. Mm. Who y'all got winning this? You know, I got Cash Money, man.
I'm not a Lone Limit soldier. I'm not a soldier.
You got No Limit?
No.
They got Make You Say about it, Down For My Niggas, How You Do That.
My dude.
But Cash Money got Bling Bling.
Yeah, not
the
only
block
that,
is
man.
Hot. 400
it's only that,
keys.
Yeah, it's
Project
just too much.
Chick.
It's just too
you
much.
Know what I'm saying?
And I wasn't ever really a Silk the Shocker fan.
He was terrible. I don't know who liked
it. I liked it Mystical.
And he only had about 3 or 4 songs.
Yeah, he didn't have enough catalog.
Then you got C Murder.
Didn't have enough catalog.
Mia X.
It was terrible.
And Cain and Abel.
Really terrible. I prefer Mia X over all those.
Yeah, she had the best catalog. You know? Mm-hmm. Yep. But Cash Money, Juvenile, BG, Manny Fresh, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, man.
Turk. Like, man, Lil Wayne catalog alone destroys No Limit to me, man. Lil Wayne alone. Even if you go back to the Hot Boy days, if you do his first 4 albums, you know what I'm saying? You don't even got to do the newer stuff.
Man,
like, it's a wash, bro.
And then, No Limit only got...
They ain't got no hits. They, I don't know, man.
You got about 12 at the most.
They ain't got 20. Not to go against Cash Money, man. BG album. You know what I'm saying? Cash Money is army, brother.
You're in the Navy. Never try to play me.
You know what I'm saying? Bling, bling. Every time I come around the hood, bling, bling. You know what I'm saying? Like, what a. The block is hot. The block is
it's
hot.
It's just too much Cash Money.
Back that ass up. You know what I'm saying?
Get your roll on.
I'm on fire. Like, man, there's so many that Cash Money got, man. You know?
Gator boots and a dog Gucci suit.
Yeah.
Ain't got no job. What up,
like, they got some anthems.
Can't pay my rent, cause all my money's spent.
But that's okay, cause I'm still fly.
And Manny Fresh made all the beats, man. Everybody from top to bottom, man. He's a great producer. I know Nolan had Pop Beats a Pound, Pound the Beats, whatever that was called. But Manny Fresh, hey, he was in this, they had a documentary. I'm in the studio. He had Mad Records, man. He was showing how he made Back That Ass Up, man, where he took the horns and the little samples from, man, from New Orleans. They got a distinctive sound, you know?
Yeah, that dance feel.
And that Back That Ass Up can be played forever. It would never get old in the club. That song would never get old.
Never get old. Back That Ass Up.
Like, that was...
Girl, you think...
Yeah, they don't... No Limit.
You
got,
won't you...
No Limit. Songs is outdated, man. They songs didn't age well, man.
No. Not even the artist age didn't age well.
Only one aged well was Snoop.
And he was only there for a couple of albums. You know?
Master P didn't even age well.
I know, he aged horribly.
On the music?
Yeah, his songs.
It's like, damn.
Make him say, nah, 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 nah.
You have to respect his hustle, though.
Oh yeah, we ain't talking about the hustle. He's great. Him and Baby did great hustling. But we talking about the music, the lineup, and the artists. And Cash Money got this.
Got it all the way.
Mm-hmm. Hey man, I want to give a birthday shout out to Jim Jones. He turns 46 today. Did you see Juice Santana go in the jewelry shop and get that like ghost chain? Yeah, he bought a new chain yesterday for like $400,000. You know what I'm saying?
Why would he spend all the money on the chain?
I don't know, man. They was clowning him too, bro. You know what I'm saying? They was like, he too old for this. And
yeah.
Why you buying a kid chain? And you know what I'm saying? You ain't got no money like that. You should get your teeth fixed. And you know, they was
like, if he still got money.
Man, Def Jam got his masters, bro.
Oh, yeah.
And then Cameron got his other masters.
He got nothing coming.
Like, man. He just had a plain purple hoodie, man, and bought this chain. Like,
damn, $400,000.
Should have bought a crib, man.
Thanks, yeah.
Some land, a business. Forget that chain. That's crazy. These rappers be wasting mad money, dog. Hey man, we gotta well, happy birthday, Jim Jones.
Happy birthday, Capo.
Capo! On to the shoutouts, man. The number one contributors this week in the True Hip Hop group is Juliet Edmonds, Shorty Ty, Greg Diesel, Little Dion, Cherry Childs, Gregory Gaddison, and Daryl Edmond, man.
All right, y'all. That's what's up, though.
Good looking
keep
out, man.
Keep stacking that thing up.
Keep contributing. Keep participating. Keep commenting. Keep posting, man. Me and Wolf appreciate it.
Yeah, sure we love y'all.
Subscribe to this channel. We build it. We do it for y'all. For you. Wolverine, you got any shout-outs?
Shout-out to me.
Shout out to Wolverine and Grand Rapids, Michigan.
Definitely, and DJ Blaze.
One love.
Peace.